two. Yeah, testing one, testing two. अहंकार चित्ताणि नाहं न चास्त्रोह जिहवे न चाग्राम नेत्रि मनोबुद्धि अहंकार चित्ताणि नाहं न चास्त्रोह जिहवे न चाग्राम नेत्रि न चाभूम भूमिर् न तेजो न वायु चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम न चा प्राण संघ्यो न वै पंच वायुः न वा सप्त धातुर् न वा पंच कोशः न वा पाणि पादौ न चोपस्य पायु चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम न मे द्वेष रागो न मे लोभ मोह न मे वैम दो नैव मात्सर्य भाव न धर्मो न चार्थो न कामो न मोक्ष चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम न पुण्यं न पापं न सौख्यं न दुःखं न मंत्रो न तीर्थं न वेदा न यज्ञः अहं भोजनं नैव भोजन न भोक्ता चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम न मे मृत्यु शंका न मे जाति भेद पिता नैव मे नैव माताय जन्म न बंधुर्न मृत्यम गुरुर्मेव शिष्य चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम अहम् निर्विकल्पो निराकार रूपो विभुत्वच सर्वच सर्वेन्द्रियाणां नचासंघटम नैव मुक्तिर्न मेया चिदानंदरूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंदरूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंदरूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम चिदानंदरूपः शिवोहम शिवोहम। प्रेम से बोलो श्री शिव शंकर भगवान की जय। डिवोटीज, लेट अस सिट अपराइट फॉर अ फ्यू मिनट्स एज वी क्लास्प आवर हैंड्स, वी जेंटली बाव आवर हेड्स एंड वी क्लोज आवर आईज इन प्रेयर एंड ध्यानम एज वी बिगिन दिस इवनिंग दिस 10th एडिशन ऑफ द प्रोग्राम शिवोहम। वी टेक अ डीप ब्रेथ, वी से सो एज वी इनहेल एंड एज वी एक्सहेल वी से हम वंस मोर सो Exhale with hum. Inhale again, so. As we exhale, we say hum. Hari Om. Hari Om. Hari श्री गणेशाय नमः। श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। श्री गुरु चरण कमलेभ्यो नमः। गुरुर् ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः। गुरुर् साक्षात् परम ब्रह्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। या देवी सर्वभूतेषु मातृरूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्यै नमो नमः। कर्पूर गौरं करुणावतारं संसार सारं भुजगेन्द्रहारं सदा वसन्तं हृदयारविन्दे भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि। अतुलित बलधामं एम शैलाबदेहं धनुजवन कृशानुं ज्ञानिनामग्रगण्यं सकल गुण निधानं वानराणामधीशं रघुपति प्रिय भक्तं वात जातं नमामि। वसुदेव सुतं देवं कंसचानूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं। यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य ग्लानिर्भवति भारत अभ्युत्थानमस धर्मस्य तदात्मानं सृजाम्यहं। परित्राणाय साधूनं विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्मसंस्थार्पणाथाय शंभवामि युगे युगे। ॐ भूर्भुवस्वः तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो न प्रचोदयात्। हरि ओम हरि ओम हरि ओम। प्रेम से बोलो गजानन स्वामी की। Jai, 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 Jai Ganapati. Devotees, this evening we now go to the very first pages of the Sri Ramcharitamanas, written by Goswami Tulsidas Ji, this beautiful verse, this Doha, dedicated to none other than Mother Vani, the goddess of speech, to control our tongues, Mother Saraswati, the goddess of knowledge. Pratama Pujya, Lord Ganesha, Vinayaka, the remover of obstacles, and of course the sage Valmiki. We go to Balkan, the very first shloka. Varnanam Arthasanghanam Rasanam Chandasamapi Mangalanam Che Kartaro Vande Vani Vinayako Bhavani Shankaro Vande Shraddha Vishwas Rupino Yabhyam Binana Pashyanti Siddhaha Swantastam Ishwaram Vande Bodhamayam Nityam Gurum Shankar Rupinam Yamashritohi Vakropi Chandraha Sarvata Vandatye Sitaram Gunagram Punya Aranya Vrivahrino Vande Vishudh Vigyano Kavishwar Kapishwarah Prem Se Bolo Bhagwan Ram Chandra Ki Jai 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 Sitaram Sab Koi Namaste, good evening, Sai Ram, Jai Guru Datta, Sat Sri Akal. Welcome, welcome this evening, brothers and sisters, to this, our 10th edition of the program, Shivoham. Shivoham, universal healing through oneness. Devotees, welcome to all joining us from all parts of the world this evening. If you have a minute, and you are live on, we are live on Facebook, of course, Facebook Live, and of course on YouTube as well, on Akashvani 106.5 FM in Trinidad, and also on Swarag HD. Thank you, DJ Mamu, Kavita Ramnarayanji, and of course Hema Ramnarayan, Sharma Ramnarayanji, and all of you for broadcasting and streaming this program live. Devotees, while we have a few minutes before we begin this evening, I ask you to share this feed on your pages, on your walls. Invite your friends and relatives to join this program, just as you would invite them when you're having a puja at home. Invite them to share in this bliss, in this satsang, in this joyous occasion as we celebrate this evening, Shivoham. Have you ever noticed that the divine depictions of Hindu deities always have their hands filled with different instruments, willing and ready to serve those who worship them? Always giving, always ready. Look at Lord Ganesha, for example. He holds in one hand an axe, in another a rope, in another a dish of sweets, modak, while pouring out blessings to his spiritual seekers. What is the spiritual significance of this? Have you ever asked this question? One of the names of Lord Ganesha, as we all know very well, is Sri Vighneshwara, Vighneshwara. He who removes obstacles. And in this four-armed form, we come to understand symbolically how he removes obstacles. How does he do this? You see, in his four arms, he uses the following tools to aid his devotees on their spiritual journey. The axe that he uses is to chop off worldly attachments to objects, situations, people, emotions and thoughts. The rope is to rope in your attention towards the divine and hold it right there, moving you in closer and closer and closer to self-realization, Atma Tattva. We've been speaking about this. The modhaks, or the sweets, are fed to the devotees along their paths. This symbolizes the bliss of satisfaction that devotees will experience as they move closer and closer and closer to their true nature. Blessings which he is pouring out to the devotees now for greater and greater spiritual evolution. This is a beautiful reminder of the spiritual journey that we are all on. We are embarked on this spiritual journey. Dwelling on his loss, on this loss, we can create. Sometimes, you know, it gets rough as our attachments get chopped away with the axe, you know, losing attachment, losing things that are close, near and dear to us. And dwelling on this loss sometimes can create mental depression, emotional chaos, and even physical ailments. In a time of loss, when we have a choice, we can either move in a direction of worship towards God, or we can plummet deeper and deeper and deeper into a world of anger, resentment, or addiction. Hopefully, neither of the last three are true, devotees. It is highly recommended that in this time, in this day and age, especially in this pandemic that we are experiencing, this COVID-19 pandemic, to worship, to focus on worship and have faith in that indeed the obstacles in our path shall be removed. Worshipping Lord Ganesha is a sure way to move through your pains, to remove any obstacles in your past, and to make our lives exceptional. Who here doesn't want an exceptional life on this broadcast this evening? Have faith and surrender your past to him. He will rope in your attention closer and closer and never let you go. You know, like a loving ally, loving friend, he will feed you the sweet experience of great joy and satisfaction, such that you will not want to ever focus on your painful past ever again. Then forgiveness sets in, healing you mentally, emotionally, and physically. Have faith in this process, devotees. Have faith that this sweetness will find you even today. If it even seems today that the going is rough, expect great things as we now sing the praises of Ganapati Bhagwan. We call upon him, O Ganeshji, to rid us, O Lord, the remover of obstacles, Ek Dant Dayavant Chara Bhujadhari, and remove this COVID-19 pandemic from this planet. Let Lord Shiva take it and drink it like the halahal poison and save this universe. Prem se bolo Vinayak Bhagavan, Ganesh Bhagavan ki jai. I want you all now to bring out your musical instruments. Bring out your musical instruments, your majiras, your tablas, your dholaks, your nals, your kabasas, your shakshaks, your tambourines, your chal, your hands to clap, keyboards. If you do not have musical instruments, get a lota and two spoons like we used to do long ago. Let us sing. Prem se bolo Gajanan Swami ki.
O jai jai Ganapati, jai Ganapati, jai Ganesh, jai Ganapati, jai 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 Ganapati, jai Ganapati, jai Ganesh, jai Ganapati, jai jai. Ganapati Vighna Vinashan Hari, Ganapati Vighna Vinashan Hari, Ganapati Vighna Vinashan Hari, Ganapati Vighna Vinashan Hari.
Prem se bolo.
O jai jai Ganapati, jai Ganapati, jai Ganesh, jai Ganapati, jai.
Let me hear you.
Jai jai Ganapati.
Beautiful.
O jai Ganapati, jai Ganesh, jai Ganapati, jai jai.
Devotees, whatever the problems are that you are facing today in life, whatever the trials and tribulations are, whatever the challenges are, I want you to place it to that feet of Bhagwan Sri Ganesha and imagine that he's taking that rope now and that axe, and he's cutting away all those negativities. As we make this offering to him, we ask you to say, Prem se bolo Gajanan Swami ki.
Lambodhar Pitambar Sohe Arimali Mukutan Yan Ratnare. Lambodhar Pitambar Sohe Arimali Mukutan Yan Ratnare. Gajmali Mal Gale Vijh Sohe, Gajmani Mal Gale Vijh Sohe. Bal Lal Me Chandri Kalave. Ganapati Vighna Vinashan Hari, Ganapati Vighna Vinashan Hari, गणपति विघ्न विनाशन हारी, गणपति विघ्न विनाशन हारी।
प्रेम से बोलो
ओ जय जय गणपति, जय गणपति
बोलो,
जय गणेश जय
ब्यूटीफुल बोलो,
जय जय गणपति, जय गणपति, जय गणेश जय गणपति, जय जय मोधक लेत देत जननी, जब ठुमक चलत नूर उलझन कारे, मोधक लेत देत जननी, जब ठुमक चलत नूर उलझन कारे, रिधि सिद्धि दाओ चबर दुलावत, रिधि सिद्धि दाओ चबर दुलावत, सुर समोह लखी मोध सुखावे, गणपति विघ्न विनाशन हारी, गणपति विघ्न विनाशन हारी, गणपति विघ्न विनाशन हारी, गणपति विघ्न विनाशन हारी। ओ जय जय गणपति, जय गणपति, जय गणेश जय गणपति, जय 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 गणपति, जय गणपति, जय गणेश जय गणपति, जय जय।
I want you to clap your hands now, devotees. We clap our hands and we sing and of course is
Moriya Moriya Ganapati Baba Moriya, oh Moriya Moriya Ganapati Baba,
prem se bolo
Moriya Moriya Ganapati Baba Moriya, Moriya Moriya Ganapati Baba Moriya, Moriya 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 re, Moriya 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 re, Moriya 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 re, Moriya 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 re, jay jay ganapati, jay ganapati, jay ganesh jay ganapati, jay
oh
jay jay ganapati, jay ganapati, jay ganesh jay ganapati, jay 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 ganesh jay ganapati, jay 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 ganesh jay गणपति, जय जय।
प्रेम से बोलो गजानन स्वामी की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय, पवन पुत्र हनुमान की जय। आई कैन सी, आई कैन फील द एनर्जी दैट यू आर एमिनेटिंग टुनाइट, सो पावरफुल इनडीड, जस्ट बाय सिंगिंग एंड चैंटिंग एंड ग्लोरीफाइंग द नेम ऑफ भगवान, गणपति भगवान। नाउ from the feet of Ganesh Bhagwan we go to our gurus. In our lives, as you know, we all have gurus. If we were never, as we say in colloquialism, we say christened, or we have taken that janeva sanskar from a spiritual guru, our mothers and fathers are our first guru, prathama guru. My parents are on tonight, Pandit Sri Tulsi Prasadji and my mom Mrs. Grace Prasadji, watching, tuned in tonight on Facebook Live, all the way from Trinidad. Mom and Dad, your ashirvad, your pranams, your blessings always to you. To all of our gurus tonight, I want you to imagine, to bring that image of your guru. Those of you who have gurus, those of us, bring that image of your guru to the center of your forehead. And I want you to gently close your eyes and sing along with me as we say, oh Gurudev, we bow to you, oh supreme noble teacher, my Lord who is from Om, this Lord of Parthi, the Lord of this universe, the Lord of Prashanti Nilayam, Lord Sai, our Guru. Prem Sabalo Shri Guru Maharaj Ki.
Guru Devaya Namo Namah, गुरुदेवाया नमो नमः, ए परमेश्वर नमो नमः, ए परमेश्वर नमो नमः, गुरुदेवाया नमो नमः, गुरुदेवाया नमो नमः।
व्हाटएवर ए नेम, व्हाटएवर दैट इमेज ऑफ योर गुरु,
I want you to imagine tonight that Guru is seated on a chair or in an ashram or even on the floor, and you're going down with your heads, your forehead, and you're bowing to the feet of that Guru, and you're saying, you're taking that Ashirvad, that blessing from the Guru, the blessing from the feet of that Guru, and you're saying, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Deva Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Guru Devaya Namo Namah. Guru Devaya Namo Namah. E Parameshwar Namo Namah. E Parameshwar Namo Namah. Guru Devaya Namo Namah. Guru Devaya Namo Namah. Omkaraya Namo Namah. Omkaraya Namo Namah. Partipurishwara Namo Namah. Partipurishwara Namo Namah. Jagadishwaraya Namo Namah. Jagadishwaraya Namo Namo. Prashantishwar Namo Namo. Prashantishwar Namo Namo. Gurudevaya Namo Namo. Gurudevaya Namo Namo. E Parameshwar Namo Namo. E Parameshwar Namo Namo. Gurudevaya Namo Namo. Gurudevaya Namo Namo. Omkaraya Namo Namo. Omkaraya Namo Namo. Partipurishwar Namo Namo. Partipurishwar Namo Namo. Jagadishwaraya Namo Namo. Jagadishwaraya Namo Namo. Prashantishwar Namo Namo. Prashantishwar Namo Namo. Prem se bolo. Gurudevaya Namo Namo. Gurudevaya Namo Namo. Gurudevaya Namo Namo. Gurudevaya Namo Namo. Prem se bolo Shri Guru Maharaj ki. My dear brothers and sisters, once again, Sitaram Namaste. Good evening. Sat Sri Akal. Jai Guru Datta. Om Sai Ram. Welcome, Swagatam, welcome again to this, our 10th edition of the program, Shivoham. Let's take a minute to call our friends and relatives, share this invitation with them, just as you would again when you're having a puja at home, so they can all share in this devotion tonight, this session of devotion. Let us lift our collective spirits of spiritual healing and vibrations all across this planet, to every single home, to every single soul, to every single heart. This is a virtual collaborative satsang, and we shall all participate as we have been doing by singing, chanting, playing our instruments, and where possible as well, lots of clapping and singing with our hands as well, okay? Tonight, we begin by chanting the 40 glorious verses of the Sri Hanuman Chalisa. This potent, most potent form of spiritual medication given to mankind by Goswami Tulsidas Ji. Kavi Samrat Sahit Chakravarti Goswami Tulsidas Ji. As we sing tonight the 40 verses of Sri Hanuman Chalisa.
Shri Guru Charan Saroj Raju Nij Man Mukura Sudhari Varno Raghuvar Bimal Jashu जोढायकु फल चारी बुद्धि ही न तनु जानिके सुमिरो पवन कुमार बल बुढ़ी वेद्या देहु मोही हरहु कलेश विकार.
I want you to feel the energy as we sing and we clap and we chant and we glorify. प्रेम से बोलो पवन पुत्र हनुमान की.
जय हनुमान ज्ञान गुण सागर जय कपीश तिहु लोक.
बोलो
राम दूत अटुलित बल धामा अंजनी पुत्र पवन सुत नामा महावीर विक्रम बजरंगी कुमत निवार सुमति के संगी कंचन वरण विराज सुवेशा कानन कुंडल कुंज.
जय श्री राम.
हाट वज्र और ध्वजा विराजे कांधे मूंज जनेऊ साजे शंकर सुवर्ण केसरी नंदन तेज प्रताप महाजगवंदन विद्यावान गुणीयति चातुर राम काज करिवे को आतुर प्रभु चरित्र सुनिवे को रसिया राम लखन सीता मन बसिया सूक्ष्म रूप धरि सियहि दिखावा विकत रूप धरि लंक जरावा भीम रूप धरि असुर संहारे रामचंद्र के काज सवारे लाए संजीवन लखन जियाए श्री रघुवीर हरषि उर लाए रघुपति कीनी बहुत बड़ाई तुम मम प्रिय भरत ही सम भाई सहस्त्र बदन तुम्हारो यस गावे अस कै श्रीपति कंठ लगावे सनकादिक ब्रह्मादि मुनीषा नारद शारद सहित यहीसा जम कुबेर दिगपाल जहाते कवि कोविद कही सखई कहाते तुम उपकार सुग्रीव ही कीन्हा राम मिलाए राजपट तुम्हारो मंत्र भी भीषण माना लंकेश्वर भय सब जग जाना युग सहस्त्र योजन पर भानु लील्योता ही मधुर फल जानु प्रभु मुद्रिका मिली मुख माही जल ढिलांघी गए अक्षर जनाई दुर्गम काज जगत के जेते सुगमय अनुग्रह तुम्हारे देते राम दुवारे तुम रखवारे होत नया ज्ञा बिनु पैसारे सब सुख लहै तुम्हारी शरणा तुम रक्षक का हो को डरना अपन तेज संहारो आपे तीन हुलोक हाकते कापे भूत पिसाच निकट नहीं आवे महावीर जब नाम सुनावे नाशे रोग हरे सब पीरा जपत निरंतर हनुमत वीरा संकट ते हनुमान चुरावे मन क्रम वचन ध्यान जोलावे सब पर राम तपस्वी राजा तिनके काज सकल तुम साजा और मनोरथ जो कोई लावे सोई अमित जीवन फल पावे चारो जुग परताप तुम्हारा है पर सिद्ध जगत उजियारा साधु संत के तुम रखवारे असुर निकंदन राम दुलारे अष्ट सिद्धि नवनिधि के दाता असवर दीन जानकी माता राम रसायन तुम्हारे पासा सदा रहो रघुपति के दासा तुम्हारे भजन राम को पावे जन्म जन्म के दुख बिसरावे अंत काल रघुबर पुर जाई जहाँ जमन हरि भक्त कहाई और देवता चित्त न धरही हनुमत से ही सर्व सुख करई संकट कटे मिटे सब पीरा जो सुबिरे हनु
बोलो
जय 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 हनुमान गोसाई कृपा करहु गुरुदेव की नाही जो सत पार पाठ कर कोई छूते ही बंधी महासुख होई जो यह पढ़े हनुमान चालीसा ओ इसे धीसा की गौरीसा तुलसीदास सदा हरिचेरा ई जय नाथ हृदय महादेरा पवन तने संकट हरणम मंगलमूर्ति रूप राम लखन सीता सहित हृदय बसहु सुरभूप पवन सुत हनुमान की जय
प्रेम से बोलो पवन पुत्र हनुमान की अकांठेयु प्रेम से बोलो पवन पुत्र हनुमान की जय बजरंग बली जय श्री राम महावीर स्वामी की जय
डिवोटीज अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल अ वेरी वंडरफुल अ वेरी डिवाइन एंड प्लेजेंट गुड इवनिंग टू ईच एंड एवरी वन ऑफ यू शिवोहम शिवोहम यूनिवर्सल हीलिंग थ्रू वननेस आवर 10th एपिसोड टुनाइट आई वांट टू वेलकम टुनाइट दिस वर्चुअल ऑडियंस फेसबुक लाइव यूट्यूब लाइव Akashvani, Swarg HD, and wherever you are tuned in, listening to us tonight, mothers, fathers, gurus, revered pundits, uncles and aunties, nieces and nephews, brothers and sisters, friends and relatives, children. Blessed are we to be amongst each other tonight in this virtual collaborative session. We give praise and thanks to Bhagwan as we begin this evening. We have just beautifully sung and chanted Shri Hanuman Chalisa, the 40 glorious verses to Pavana Putta Hanumanji Mahavir Swami, the Lord of this century, the Lord of this age. We continue tonight by chanting again the name of Bhagwan in this beautiful bhajan. It says, Victory, Jaya Jagadish Hare, victory to the Lord of this universe. And who do we speak of? जगदीश हरे सत्यनारायण भगवान प्रेम से बोलो श्री सत्यनारायण भगवान की लॉर्ड विष्णु हिमसेल्फ गोविंद हु रिजाइड्स एंड हु रेस्क्यूज अस ही रिजाइड्स इन द हेवनली रीजंस यू आर द इटर्नल हैप्पीनेस नित्यानंद यू आर द सुप्रीम ब्लिस ब्रह्मानंद यू आर द इटर्नल victory O Lord victory and protector O Gopala Om we chant the name of Shiva Shivoham who resides in the sacred mountains at Arunachala Shiva who holds the dhari the trident the trishula Om we chant the name of Narayanam who is the true abode of all beings victory to the goddess Bharati who carries dharini the whole universe Vishwa in her hands O Mother, O Mata, you are endless. You are the resource of nourishment. Annapurna, the bhajan tells us. Let us glorify Bhagwan as we sing beautifully. I'd like all of you again to blend your voices. Let us glorify.
Prem se bolo shri Satyanarayan Bhagwan ki.
Jai Jagadish Hare. Jai Govind. हरे जय जगदीश हरे जय गोविंद हरे नित्यानंदा ब्रह्मानंदा जय गोपाल हरे
सिंग डिवोटीज
जय नित्यानंदा ब्रह्मानंदा जय गोविंद हरे अरुणाचल शिव अरुणाचल शिवा त्रिशूलधारी शिवो हरि नारायण ओ साई नारायण ओ स्वामी हरि नारायण ओ साई नारायण ओ जय देवी भारती विश्वदायिनी अन्नपूर्ण माता जय देवी भारती विश्वदायिनी अन्नपूर्ण माता ओम सिंग इट मी बोलो
जय जगदीश हरे जय गोविंद हरे
बोलो
जय जगदीश हरे जय गोविंद हरे नित्यानंद ब्रह्मानंद जय गोपाल हरे साई नित्यानंद ब्रह्मानंद जय गोपाल हरे
clap your hands devotees let's call upon him
अरुणाचल शिवा त्रिशूलधारी शिवो अरुणाचल शिव त्रिशूलधारी शिव हरि नारायण ओ साई नारायण ओ
जय भोलेनाथ
हरि नारायण ओ साई नारायण ओ जय देवी भारती विद्यादायिनी अन्नपूर्ण माता जय देवी भारती विद्यादायिनी अन्नपूर्ण माता
जय जगदीश हरे जय गोविंद हरे
प्रेम से बोलो श्री सत्यनारायण भगवान की कैन यू फील द एनर्जी कैन यू फील द एनर्जी दैट यू हैव जस्ट एमिनेटेड जस्ट बाय सिंगिंग एंड कॉलिंग अपॉन दैट सत्यनारायण भगवान द लॉर्ड ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्स माय डियर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स टुनाइट I will be quoting from the golden pages of our scriptures, the Bhagavad Gita, and discourses from Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. In our previous discussions or Shivoham sessions, we looked at unity is divinity and purity is enlightenment. Most recently touching on what purity means and why is purity so important. You see, Swami says that just as we see different reflections of ourselves when we are surrounded by mirrors, the apparent multiplicity around us is just the many reflections of the one self, which is our reality. I want you to keep this in mind tonight. Realization of this fundamental unity, that it's just one, would lead to purity of the mind. And just for a recap again, once more, the steps that we have covered so far, we have firstly charity. And again, charity not for dana, not for dakshina, but charity of removing all of the negativities from our bodies and lives. Then we have purity. Then comes divinity. And then comes Atma Tattva realization with Bhagwan, devotees. Tonight, we are going to explore two kinds of purity, the external and the internal. Examining some of the most external factors that affects the impulses and how to develop this concept called purity. We all want to be pure. We all wish to live this life of purity. As we progress in future sessions to come, we shall also cover how to practice purity, very important in this day and age of Kali. Also, how to know if you have developed purity. How have we developed purity? We will delve into examples or the exemplars of purity from our scriptures tonight, along the way with each of the sessions exploring what are the milestones on this path of purity. What are the fruits we will receive at each stage of achieving purity? And what are the pitfalls? Very important to remember. What are the pitfalls that we may encounter in this pursuit of purity? Tonight, our focus will be on the story of Bhakta Prahalad, a young disciple or young Bhakta of Lord Vishnu. Let us first grasp, though, the two kinds of purity and how to develop purity. Because you all understand, you have heard the story of Prahaladji, I'm sure, many, many times. We're going to take a different approach tonight and relate the story of Prahalad to the concept of purity. Purity, saucham as it's called, is of two kinds, external and internal. Both inner and outer purity are important. They are essential for man's physical and mental health. Most people today are only concerned with the external physical cleanliness. Once the outside is clean, we're good to go. Mm-mm. It doesn't work like that. People tend to ignore the inner cleanliness in the belief that the heart and mind are not visible to others. You can hide it. Not so, devotees. Not so. Isn't God here, there, and everywhere? But you must realize that the physical body is made up of the five elements, and one day it will return to the dust sometime or the other. It is the state of the spirit that is important. Even the body should be regarded as the abode of the spirit and cared for as such, not so? However pure the ingredients may be, if you're preparing food, however pure those ingredients may be, if the vessel in which they are cooked is not clean, that food will be spoiled. You see, for a man, his heart is like the vessel, and he must see that it is kept pure and untainted at all times. Let me give you another good example. This physical body is compared to a city with 9 gates, right? The 9 gates that dwell in this body. What are those nine gates? Sorry. The 9 gates are the 2 eyes, right? The 2 ears, the 2 nostrils, the 1 mouth, and our 2 excretory organs. These make up the 9 gates in the human body. My dear devotees, bodily refuse is expelled through one of these 9 gates, or if not all of them. In addition, there are numerous pores, right? Pores, P-O-R-E-S, all over the skin through which unwanted substances are expelled in the form of sweat or perspiration. It is our daily experience that much maintenance is required to keep this body extremely pure, not so? Like its physical counterpart, the inner instrument also needs some maintenance to keep it clean and pure. That inner instrument, the heart or the mind. What does purity mean in this context? It means total purity of thoughts, motives, feelings, and emotions and character, and is the second divine quality described by Bhagwan Sri Krishna in the 16th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. What does he say? I quote Bhagavad Gita, chapter 16. Manah prasadah saumyatvam maunam atma vinigrahah bhavasya shuddhir ityaitat tapo manasam ujjate. Bhagwan Shri Krishna Chandra ki jai. Lord Krishna says to Arjuna in this chapter, in this verse, he says, serenity of thought, gentleness of silence, self-control, and purity of purpose, all these are declared as the austerity of the mind, O Arjuna. Elevate yourselves, he says, elevate yourselves to the power of the mind and do not degrade yourself. For the mind can be the friend, but it can also be the enemy of the self. What do I mean by this? How quickly can you go from a positive demeanor to one of worry or negative? Just by the mind. Just by thinking of something that's adharmic or maybe a negative experience that you have had in the past, you automatically can go there. Brothers and sisters, let us use the mind not to go down. You know, Michelle Obama once says, when they go low, we go high, right? I quote, I'm not a politician. Devotees, do not step low. Always reach for the stars, as the saying says. The mind may be likened to a garden, right? In springtime now in here in North America, a lot of people are doing gardening. I know my brother Ken in Atlanta and his family have planted a beautiful vegetable garden. We are going to come up there soon to reap this. The mind might be likened to a garden, which can either be intelligently cultivated or allowed to run wild with what? If you don't take care of the garden, what happens? Weeds, bush, as we say in Trinidad, right? What do we mean by this? You see, gardeners will cultivate their plot, growing fruits, flowers, and vegetables. At the same time, they will ensure that it remains free from weeds. Yes, weeds, parasites. Similarly, we must cultivate our mind with rich and noble thoughts, while weeding out the negative and debilitating thoughts, devotees. If we allow resentful, hateful, blaming, unforgiving, critical, and condemning thoughts to reside in our mind, they will have a debilitating effect on our personality, and that is something we do not want. We can never get a fair amount of constructive action out of the mind until we have learned to control it and keep it from becoming stimulated by anger, hatred, dislike, etc. Kama, krodha, lobha, ahankar, and so forth. These are the weeds that choke out the manifestation of the divine grace within our hearts, devotees. There are some maxims that I will share with you tonight. One great writer says, "Watch your thoughts, for they become your words." Watch your thoughts, for they become your words. Watch your words, for they become your actions. Watch your actions, for they become habits. Watch your habits, for they become character. And watch your character, because it becomes your destiny. How do we live up to these maxims each day? Live each day as though it was your last day on this world. Mahatma Gandhi tells us, you know, one of my favorite writers, again, from last week, I quoted her, Miss Seema M. Diwan. She says, Bhagwan speaks, she says, "Say no to anger." We're controlling the mind now. "Say no to anger. Say no to envy. Say no to greed. Say yes to me, Bhagwan. Say no to hatred. Say no to jealousy. Say no to fear. Say yes to me, Bhagwan. Say no and end this way forever. Say yes and start your peace with me, Bhagwan." How do we live up again to these maxims? Again, this bhajan will tell us tonight. With a flame of love burning for the Lord through the imperishable devotion, with the mind perpetually attached to Him, a devotee is guaranteed to find the Lord. Let the divine sentiments flow in the heart. Transform your heart into a village where He can reside. The mind will deluge with ecstasy. Let the spark of faith shine resplendently and remove the rancors of impurities from your mind. Let the compassion flow like a stream, and the Lord will surely visit. Don't we all want the Lord to surely visit us? We sing bhajan. You all know this bhajan very well. Join with me and clap your hands. Follow.
प्रेम की अगन हो भक्ति सगन हो मन में लगन हो तो पर प्रभु मिल जाएंगे प्रभु मिल जाएंगे बोलो प्रभु मिल जाएंगे प्रभु मिल जाएंगे प्रेम की अगन हो भक्ति सगन हो मन में लगन हो तो प्रभु मिल जाएंगे प्रभु मिल जाएंगे प्रभु मिल जाएंगे प्रभु मिल जाएंगे.
We open up our hearts now. We say, Bhagwan, my heart is pure, Lord. Come reside in my heart and stay in there forever, Lord. All my words, thoughts and deeds, may they all be purified.
हृदय में भाव हो अनुनय की छाव हो हृदय में भाव हो अनुनय की छाव हो आराधन का गाओ तो मन खिल जाएंगे मन खिल जाएंगे मन खिल जाएंगे तो प्रेम की अगन हो भक्ति सगन हो मन में लगन हो तो प्रभु मिल जाएंगे प्रभु मिल जाएंगे प्रभु मिल जाएंगे प्रभु मिल जाएंगे श्रद्धा की जोत हो मन में न खोत हो श्रद्धा की जोत हो मन में न खोत हो करुणा का स्रोत हो तो प्रभु श्री आएंगे, प्रभु श्री आएंगे, प्रभु श्री आएंगे, प्रभु श्री आएंगे। तो प्रेम की अगन हो, भक्ति सगन हो, मन में लगन हो तो
बोलो
प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाए।
जय श्री राम।
श्रद्धा चरणों की चाह हो, भक्ति प्रवाह हो, चरणों की चाह हो, भक्ति प्रवाह हो, पूजा की राह हो तो प्रभु हर्षाएंगे, प्रभु हर्षाएंगे, प्रभु हर्षाएंगे, प्रभु हर्षाएंगे। तो प्रेम की अगन हो, भक्ति सगन हो, मन में लगन हो तो प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे।
Devotees, we develop an ardent desire to touch the feet of the Lord, not so? Invigorate ourselves with the devotion and walk the path, engaging on His worship. This is pleasing to the Lord. We sing His praises like we are tonight. We sing His praises, we clap our hands and we call upon Him. Infuse the positive energy of Bhagwan into our every single blood cell in our bodies, so that when our heart pumps, all the organs in our body, they only listen to one calling, and that is Jai Shri Ram.
Bhajanon ki bol ho, anmol khol ho, भजनों की बोल हो, भाव अनमोल हो, अर्चन की मोल हो तो प्रभु मुस्काएंगे, प्रभु मुस्काएंगे,
बोलो
प्रभु मुस्काएंगे, प्रभु मुस्काएंगे। तो प्रेम की अगन हो, भक्ति सगन हो, मन में लगन हो तो प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे। नारायण धन हो, छवि में मगन हो, नारायण धन हो, छवि में मगन हो, अर्चन बंधन हो तो प्रभु दर्शाएंगे, प्रभु दर्शाएंगे, प्रभु दर्शाएंगे, प्रभु दर्शाएंगे।
तो
प्रेम की अगन हो, भक्ति सगन हो, मन में लगन हो तो प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे,
तो
प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे,
तो
प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे।
प्रेम से बोलो श्री सत्यनारायण भगवान की
जय।
प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे।
Devotees, next time you go in front of your altar to pray, to speak to your Bhagwan, I want you to use these words.
प्रभु मिल जाएंगे, प्रभु मिल जाएंगे।
Give me that blessing, O Lord. I come before you, I submit before you, O Lord. Fill my heart with love, with blessings for you, Prabhu. Swamiji tells us again tonight, we speak of purity now from a very young age. I want you to listen to these points very, very carefully, very strong points. The lifespan of an average man in the Kali Yuga age, which we are in now, is very short. And what do we mean by this? In the Dwapar Yuga, the previous age, it was much longer. At the time of the Mahabharata war, Lord Krishna was 76 years old. Arjuna was 74 years old. And Bhishma, the commander-in-chief of the Kaurava army, was 112 years old. You see, in the Dwapar Yuga, a man 70 years of age was considered to be a young boy. But today, even a 17-year-old boy is weak like an old man. What is the reason for this? You see, in those days, the hearts of people were very sacred because they practiced something called the three P's. The three P's. What are those three P's? One, purity. Two, patience. Three, perseverance. Purity, patience, and perseverance. The three P's. I want you to remember these tonight. Make a note of them. By practicing these three P's, they remained ever young. Students from an early age and everyone should practice these principles, the three P's. Number one, how do we do it? Fill their hearts with the love for God such that all they see, all they speak, all they hear, and all they do for should ever be sacred. Devotees, if you throw a stone in a well with water, it will give rise to waves, ripple effect, right? Those of us who study physics, you will know that waves, they generate, they propagate, right? Until they reach a certain point where they will reverberate from, or reverberate, sorry. How far will those waves go? They will spread to the entire well, not so in a circle, and go up to the edge where it will stop. Similarly, when you drop a stone of good or bad thoughts in the lake of your minds, its effect will spread through your entire body. If it is a bad thought, your eyes, your ears, your tongue will see and hear and speak all that is evil. Your hands will also perform the evil actions, and your feet will take you to undesirable places. Devotees, the effect of your thoughts will spread your entire being right from head to toe. Therefore, the heart is very important. Purification. Number two. While making friends, do not hate anybody. Do not harm anyone. Some people earn the trust and so-called friendship of friends at the expense of others, sometimes even their own friends and relatives. Isn't this so? Breaking trust and siding with people conveniently to earn their friendship, it's an unreproachable sin, devotees. Please be very careful with this. Recognize that all beings, from the smallest insect to the highest, there is God. This awareness will make the mind become pure. One must have a body that is free from the taint of himsa, which is violence or harm. Men commit many acts of violence, you know, and many sinful acts with these hands. The body has been given to man primarily for practicing dharma, righteousness. Such a sacred gift should be used only for rendering service to others and doing godly actions. This is the way to purify the body. Number three, undertake good actions which will lead to purity of the mind. The sanctification of the five senses is the way to truth. I repeat, the sanctification of the five senses is the way to truth. If the senses are polluted, of what avail are the spiritual exercises? What do we mean by this? If someone has bad intentions, and by the way, I'm not criticizing or condemning anyone, but it stems from the highest level, from the spiritualist down to the yajman. If the mind is foul, if the mind has bad intentions, bad thoughts, what good, what avail are the spiritual exercises? Examine this very carefully. Eh? When the water in the tank is polluted, all taps can only give you polluted water, brothers and sisters. One should not act in his fantasies dictate. Before doing anything, one should consider whether it is proper or improper. Nothing should be done in haste on the impulse of the moment. Nothing should be done in haste on the impulse of the moment. Think before you act. As they say, student's companion, stop, look, listen before you cross the street. You all remember this book? Very good book. It's available on, never mind, I'm not selling books tonight. Only then, brothers and sisters, one's action will be sattvic or pure and free from rajasic, stimulating or tamasic, dueling feelings. And the fourth one, keep the company of the wise and good people, which will develop into detachment and love of silence and solitude, promoting the disappearance of any delusion, which is called moha, which according to Arjuna is the fruit of listening to the Bhagavad Gita and recognizing that the truth is self within. And what is that truth that is self within? Chidananda Rupa Shivoham Shivoham. That is the concept. That is the concept that we speak about. Shivoham Shivoham. Swami continues, he says, you have to also cleanse the senses, the instruments of action and knowledge, and remove all the blemishes of bad habit, bad tendencies, and feelings and thoughts. Render yourselves always steady and unselfish. Then you can deserve the chance of worshiping God. Until then, the temple will be in ruins, infested with bats that can only revel in the darkness. Brothers and sisters, this body is the temple where God dwells, make no mistake, and is installed in every single one of our hearts. But it is not enough if you go on repeating this very pleasing axiom and pretend that you have joined the ranks of the good. No, devotees. To make that statement is a great responsibility, for you must behave every moment, every single moment, as if you are aware that God is within. If that is the case, there will be very little crimes, if not none. No crimes, no hatred, no anger, no hypocrisy, no deceit, no jealousy, no malice, no dishonesty. Let no one be proud about his beauty, strength, and youth. Swami teaches us, eh? Let no one be proud of his beauty, strength, or youth. The ravages of old age are ahead, make no mistake, and it will overwhelm him, that person. Even while you feel puffed by your strength and your energy as a youth, age is going to creep up to you inevitably one day to come. And when that body becomes bent and wrinkles on the face and bleared eyes, the old man becomes nothing but a butt of jokes for juveniles who call him an old monkey. What is lasting in all of this? What is lasting in all of this, devotees, I ask you tonight? Everything is subject to change and decay in this world. Make no mistake. Whether it be physical objects or individuals that are transient and impermanent. Nothing is lasting, only your purity is permanent. And remember, we spoke about the spiritual bank account? That bank account, the purity that you develop in this age, will yield interest to that spiritual bank account. One day to come, we withdraw from that spiritual bank account. Brothers and sisters, purity is the essential nature of man. But if man leads a polluted life, he is going to degrade himself. This next bhajan, devotees, tells us tonight. And I want to ask you tonight, in your chat sessions, in your chat windows tonight, type into me one word that you can link tonight to purity. What, in your thoughts, what is one word that links you to purity? Type it into your chat windows tonight, those of you on Facebook and YouTube Live as well. As we sing this next bhajan, the bhajan tells us, O Lord, how can I present myself at your door with a dirty shawl? O Lord of purity, I am completely ashamed to think that this dirty shawl I will wear when I come back to you, Lord, to account for my present deeds. Prabhu, you sent me into this world with an immaculately clean body, free from any taint of evil. But during the years, O Lord, I have lived, I have stained it with the dirt of inequality and sin that will encompass numerous births to come. Lord, how can I now remove these innumerable stains? The bhajan tells us. Padmashri, the late Daraji, Hari Om Sharanji, sings for us. You all know the bhajan very well. Sing along with me now.
Maili chadar odh ke kaise,
bolo.
Maili chadar odh ke kaise, द्वार तुम्हारे आऊं, मैली चादर ओढ़ के कैसे द्वार तुम्हारे आऊं, ए पावन परमेश्वर मेरे मन ही मन शर्माऊं, मैली चादर के कैसे। तूने मुझको जग में भेजा, निर्मल देकर काया, आकर के संसार में मैंने इसको दाग लगाया, जन्म जन्म की मैली चादर कैसे दाग चुराऊं, मैली चादर ओढ़ के कैसे। निर्मल वाणी पाकर तुझसे
नाम न तेरा गाया नैन मूड कर हे परमेश्वर कभी न तुझको ध्याया मन विरा की तारी टूटी अब क्या गीत सुनाऊं मैली चादर ओढ़ के कैसे इन पैरों से चल कर तेरे मंदिर कभी ना आया जहां जहां हो पूजा तेरी कभी ना शीश झुकाया ए हरि हर मैं हार के आया अब क्या हार चढ़ाऊं मैली चादर ओढ़ के कैसे द्वार तुम्हारे आऊं ए पावन परमेश्वर मेरे मन ही मन शर्माऊं मैली चादर ओढ़ के कैसे 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 द्वार तुम्हारे
We call upon that Lord now tonight.
ए पावन परमेश्वर मेरे मन ही मन शर्माऊं मैली चादर ओढ़ के कैसे
प्रेम से बोलो बाके वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की उमापति महादेव की शिवोहम Shivoham. Thank you so much for your responses online. So wonderful of you to participate and to be collaborative in this beautiful satsang this evening. Our katha continues this evening, devotees. We approach this topic now called Antakarana. What is Antakarana as relates to purity? Antakarana is used both in common speech and in spiritual parlance. What is the form, its nature, and its special quality, and what is its purpose? Devotees, when we inquire along these lines, we find that the mind itself takes the subtle form of antakarana, the inner activator. The inner activator. The mind assumes four forms. I want you to listen to this carefully, very carefully. Our mind assumes four forms. One, manas, buddhi, chitta, and ahamkara. Mind, intelligence, memory, and ego. Buddhi, chitta, and ahamkara are the three subtle forms of the mind. But when the mind is engaged in the thought process, it's called manas. Manas. When it is engaged in the process of inquiry and discrimination between right and wrong, it is called buddhi or intelligence. Buddhi or intelligence. And the third name is chitta. When the will or the decision-making agency of the mind is in action, that is called our chitta, making decisions. It has the function of memory, like a massive supercomputer, millions of times more powerful than that supercomputer. The third name is chitta, chitta. When the mind identifies itself with the body now in action, it is called ahamkar. Now let's be very careful with this term, Ahamkar. I am the doer. That's what ahamkar means. We hear about this word abhiman or ahamkar. Abhiman or ahamkar all the time because it identifies itself with the body. The I, the my, the me and the mine. We should identify instead with antakarana, not ahamkar. not ahankar. Ahankar, antakarana is the collective name for the manas, the mind, the buddhi, the intelligence, the chitta, the will, and the ahankar, the ego and the sense. What does Adi Shankara teach us in the very first verse of the Nirvana Shatakam? We chanted it before we began, and we chanted every single, at the beginning of every single episode of Shivoham. What is that? What does he say? You all know it very well, no? It goes like this.
Mano buddhi ahankar chittani naham nacha stroha jihave nacha grana netri nacha vum bhumir na tejo na vayo.
Sing with me.
Chidananda rupaha shivoham shivoham.
Mano buddhi ahankar chittani naham. I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am not the ego, nor the memory, I am not the ears, nor the eyes, nor the skin, nor the nose, nor I am not the space, nor the earth, nor the fire, nor the water. I am the form of consciousness and bliss. I am the eternal Shiva. I am Shiva. The purity of ahankar or antakarana as we speak, the purity of antakarana as we speak tonight. Though the body is mortal, the thoughts are immortal. The power of the thought vibrations runs across this world, make no mistake. As the heat waves, the electrical waves and the light waves radiate, the mental waves also radiate. The thought vibrations are cause for man's joy and sorrow, health and disease, war and birth and death. Man's life becomes meaningful if he conducts himself fully aware of the power of the thought of vibration. Brothers and sisters, the entire world is suffused with mental vibrations. What do I mean by this? The entire world is the very manifestation of mental vibrations, make no mistake. Hence, it is necessary to direct all our thoughts along this noble path. All action a man does emanates from internal impulses and not from external forces. All are internal impulses, not external forces. They are the reflection of this inner being. Let us delve into the story now of Bhakta Prahalad and how he developed purity. Brothers and sisters, tonight, you all know this story very well, so I'm going to focus less on the story and more on the philosophy. We're going to take a different approach to this Bhakta Prahalad as we speak of purity and how his mind was purely dedicated, devoted to whom? Satyanarayan Bhagwan, Lord Vishnu. But before doing so, I want us to all of us glorify. And you can feel the energy tonight, not so like it has been here every single night. The power, the glory, the divinity, the pure souls that are on this broadcast tonight, singing and chanting and calling that name of Bhagwan so purely, so beautifully, so reverently. May you all be blessed. May you all live a life of bliss and happiness. We pray to you. Prem Sabalosi Satyanarayan Bhagavan Ki Jai. As we glorify Lord Vishnu now with this beautiful bhajan, the bhajan tells us, let us sing the song of Sri Hari. Without the song of God, a genuine moment of happiness is impossible. Why are you lost in this transient materialistic pleasures of the world? Ultimately, everything will end in darkness. Our lives are engulfed in the pleasures of senses. It is very difficult to attain the powers of human being. Without singing the songs of God, true enjoyment is impervious. Which night is there that a light is not lit? Dear friend, the darkness resides within. There is no need to search over the mountains and forests. Confront the face of internal darkness. Light that lamp of Bhagwan. Light that lamp of divinity in our minds as we sing this beautiful bhajan. I ask all of you, type in your chats, Jai Narayan, Jai Narayan, Jai Narayan, Satya Narayan Bhagwan Ki Jai.
हरि का भजन कर वे मेरे मतिया भजन बिना ना मिले शुभ गतिया.
बोलो एवरीबॉडी.
हरि का भजन, ब्यूटीफुल, आई कैन हियर यू. ले मेरे मदिया भजन बिनाना मिले शुभ गतिया क्या विषयों में फिरता भुलानी क्या विषयों ने फिरता भुलानी अंतकाल सब नरक निशानी अंतकाल सब नरक निशानी जावत बीती कलो दिन रतिया
बोलो
हरि का भजन कर रे मेरे मदिया भजन बिनाना मिले शुभ गतिया
जय नारायण
जग दुर्लभ माँ नुशतन पाया जग दुर्लभ माँ नुशतन पाया हरि का भजन बिना काम ना आया हरि का भजन बिना काम न आया जिमी निष्फल दी पक बिन बतिया हरि का भजन कर हे मेरे मदिया भजन बिनाना मिले शुभ गतिया ब्रह्मानंद वचन हितकारी ब्रह्मानंद वचन हितकारी छोड़ जगत की झूठी यारी छोड़ जगत की झूठी यारी हरि चरणन में करो नेत्र दिया हरि का भजन कर ले मेरे मदिया भजन बिनाना मिले शुभ गतिया हरि का भजन कर ले मेरे मदिया भजन बिनाना मिले शुभ गतिया
प्रेम से बोलो श्री सत्यनारायण भगवान की टाइप इन टू योर चैट्स जय नारायण जय नारायण जय नारायण डिवोटीज Tonight, again, I want to acknowledge the presence of our viewers on Facebook Live, YouTube Live, listeners on Akashvani 106.5 FM live on the internet, and of course, Swarag HD. Thank you so much. Thank you so much this evening for tuning in. My dear brothers and sisters, devotees, Prahalad, Bhakta Prahalad, we all know that he was a devotee of Lord Vishnu, an astute devotee of Lord Vishnu. He remained unshaken in his faith for Lord Narayan despite the ordeals which his father, Hiranyakashipu, put him through. Lord Vishnu is known to have taken 10 incarnations to stop the reign of evil on this earth and bring peace and prosperity everywhere. Narasimha avatar is considered to be Lord Vishnu's 4th avatar. And he had taken the form of a half man, half lion to protect his devotee, Bhakta Prahalad. Jai Narayan. You all are wonderfully commenting and contributing and collaborating on this broadcast tonight. Jai Narayan. It is said that during the Satyuga, the sage Kashyap and his wife Diti had two sons, Hiranyakasha and Hiranyakashipu. Both were known to cause destruction and chaos everywhere and trouble the humans and devas alike. Do you know anybody like this on the face of this earth today? Hopefully not. The gods, being fed up with their atrocities, prayed to Lord Vishnu to come up with a solution to stop these two brothers. Lord Vishnu heard his devotees. He listens to his devotees' prayers and cries always. Lord Vishnu heard the cries of his devotees and took the form of a giant boar known as the Varaha Avatar to kill Hiranyakasha. And this is considered to be Lord Vishnu's third incarnation. Jai Narayan. Hiranyakashipu was not fond of Narayan. Not fond of him, sorry. Because he had killed his brother. To acquire invincible power, Hiranyakashipu left and went to Mount Mandara to perform a rigorous penance. While Hiranyakashipu was away doing penance, Sage Naraji, he brought his wife Lilavati to his Narad's ashram to protect her and the child that she was carrying from the impending onslaught that was about to take place. You see, while there at the ashram, Naraji conveyed to her his knowledge of Narayan's leelas, his teachings. Though Lilavati did not pay much attention to Narad's teachings, the child that was in her womb absorbed them and started meditating on the Maha Mantra, the potent formula, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya. Meditating on this mantra while still in the womb of his mother Lilavati, Lord Brahma was very pleased with Hiranyakashipu's penance, and he granted him the boon that he would not meet with the death either in the day or the night. Day or night, either on earth or sky, either from man or beast or from the gods. Devotees, with this boon, Hiranyakashipu became the Lord of the universe and decreed that he alone should be worshipped. When Prahalad was 5 years old, he was entrusted to the care of two teachers. They were Chanda and Amkara, both the sons of sage Kripacharya. And they were given strict instructions to him to impart all demonic traits and banish Lord Vishnu's name from his mind. Could you imagine this? Do you know anybody who has done this to a child? Impart only the demonic traits and banish Lord Vishnu's name from his child. Devotees, the teachers taught him about artha, which is wealth, kama, desires, and abstain from teaching him about the other two goals, which are dharma, righteousness, and moksha, liberation. So they taught him 2 out of 4. The teachers, though, in spite of their efforts, their best efforts, they could not create a single negative thought in Prahalad's mind. Why? They could not create a single negative thought in the mind of Prahalad. Why? If you know the answer, type it into your chat tonight. Why could they not create a single negative thought in the mind of Prahalad? Type it into your chat window. Devotees, in spite of their best efforts, the teachers could not create a single negative thought in the mind of Prahalad. As you're typing in the answers, I'm reading your comments. Thank you. He persisted in his own belief that Lord Narayan was the supreme master of the world, to be worshipped by the 9 modes of devotion, beginning with listening, smaran, listening to the glories of the Lord, and culminating in total surrender of the self, Atma Tattva. Prahalad's mind was focused on Narayan and the purity of the mind always resulted in him chanting the name of Lord Vishnu. And tonight, what better way to sing the glories of Lord Vishnu as Prahalad did with this next beautiful bhajan. It says, he says to Lord Vishnu in this bhajan, he says, "Oh Lord, I am a little child, so tiny and innocent. You are tremendously powerful and potent. Please protect me, O Lord. O guardian of all, you are my champion and my defender." Again, "You are my champion and my defender, O Lord. I have heard that you dispel the agonies of millions also now, O Lord. I implore you to remove my pains, even if you have to use your Sudarshan Chakra. For I too am your child, O Lord. Thou art the destroyer of sins. I am already reassured. Even if I meditate on you, O Lord, for a short period of time, I shall receive your blessings." The bhajan tells us tonight. Let us blend our voices and sing along with devotees. You all are singing so beautifully tonight. Sing to the top of your voices. Bring your musical instruments. Clap your hands. Prem se bolo Shri Satyanarayan Bhagavan ki.
Main ek nanha sa,
Prahlad is singing.
Main ek chota sa bachcha ho. तुम हो बड़े बलवान प्रभु जी मेरे लाज रखो. मैं एक नन्हा सा, मैं एक छोटा सा बच्चा हो. तुम हो बड़े बलवान प्रभु जी मेरे लाज रखो. 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 मैं एक नन्हा सा.
प्रहलाद जी सिंग्स, लॉर्ड विष्णु नाउ ही सिंग्स.
मैंने सुना है तुमने यहाँ पे लाखों के दुख ताले. मेरे दुख भी ताल प्रभु जी चक्र सुदन शन वाले. मैं एक नन्हा सा, मैं एक छोटा सा बच्चा हो. मुझ पे धरो कुछ ध्यान प्रभु जी मेरे लाज रखो. 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 तुमको दयालु अपना समझ के मैंने आज पुकारा. मुझे निर्बल का हाथ पकड़ लो, दे दो नाथ सहारा.
बोलो.
मैं एक नन्हा सा, मैं एक छोटा सा बच्चा हो. मैं एक छोटा सरवार, मैं भी तुम्हारा संतान. प्रभु जी मेरे लाज रखो. प्रभु जी मेरे लाज रखो. प्रभु जी मेरे लाज रखो. प्रभु जी मेरे लाज रखो.
Today, O Lord, I have come to your door, Prahalaji says, with an immense degree of hope, assured that you will find some way, O Lord, to rid me of my tribulations, O Lord. COVID-19, we come before you, Satyanarayan Bhagavan. Lord Vishnu, remove this pandemic from this planet, O Lord. Rid us, O Lord, of this calamity. I am a weak child, O Lord, Prahalaji said, who needs your strength. Help me, O Lord. O Lord, I beg of thee. I am full of imperfections, O Lord. I am lost without you, my true hero, he says.
मैं आया हूँ आज तुम्हारे द्वार पे आस लगाए. ऐसा कोई जतन करो प्रभु सांच को आज नाए.
अगेन.
मैं आया हूँ आज तुम्हारे द्वार पे आस लगाए. ऐसा कोई जतन करो प्रभु भक्त जो आज ना आए. मैं एक नन्हा सा, मैं एक छोटा सा बच्चा हूँ, बिगड़ी बना दो भगवान, प्रभु जी मेरे लाज रखो, 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 मैं एक नन्हा सा, मैं एक छोटा सा बच्चा हो, तुम हो गरे बलवान, प्रभु जी मेरे लाज रखो।
प्रेम से बोलो श्री सत्यनारायण भगवान की जय। जय जय नारायण, जय नारायण। यू ऑल आर एन अमेजिंग वंडरफुल ऑडियंस दिस इवनिंग। आई कैन फील योर एनर्जी thousands of miles away from wherever you are through the powers of the internet. I can absolutely feel your energy. Bhagwan listens to our call tonight. As we sing to him, we say to him,
Prahlad ji sing, Prabhu,
you are my master, O Lord. I am totally aware, O Lord. You listen to my calling, as he says,
Tumko dayalu apna samajhke.
What does he say?
मैंने आज पुकारा,
listen to my cry, O Lord.
मुझे निर्बल का आठ पकड़ लो, दे दो नाथ सहारा,
दे दो नाथ सहारा. I am so feeble, O Lord, but today I call upon you, O Lord, Lord Vishnu, for your help, O Lord. प्रभु, I call upon you.
शरण ले आई ना,
दर्शन दे दो प्रभु सच्चे नारायण भगवान. जय नारायण. Devotees, our katha continues. Despite several warnings from his father Hiranyakashipu, Prahlad continued to worship Lord Vishnu instead. His father then decided to poison Prahlad, but he survived. He then had the boy trampled by elephants, but the boy was still alive. He then put Prahlad in a room with venomous snakes. The snakes actually made a bed for him with their bodies. He could not be touched. Prahlad was then thrown into a valley off a mountain, came out unscathed. He was thrown into a river, but he was saved by God, Lord Vishnu. Holika, you all know this story very well, the sister of Hiranyakashipu, was blessed in a way so that she could never be burnt by fire. Hiranyakashipu placed Prahlad on the lap of Holika. She sat on a pyre. Prahlad prayed to Lord Vishnu to save him. Holika instead was burned to death. Prahlad was left unscathed. Devotees, this event, by the way, leads up to us celebrating the festival of Holika. In utter exasperation now, Hiranyakashipu finally asked Prahlad, "Who is this God that protects you? Who is this God that protects you, Prahlad? Where is he?" Prahlad realized the omnipresence of God and told his father that God was everywhere in this cosmos, from the tiniest microcosm to the mighty macrocosm. He added, "One who is a slave to his senses can never see him." I repeat, Prahlad teaches Hiranyakashipu a serious lesson tonight, perhaps the most important lesson of this katha tonight. One who is a slave to his senses can never see the face of God. Are you a slave to your senses, devotees, tonight? Type it in your chat tonight. Are you a slave to your senses? As long as we have attachment to ego, we can never see Sri Hari, though he is within and outside every single being. Hiranyakashipu then asked Prahlad, "Is he in the pillar?" Prahlad says, "Yes, he is." And Hiranyakashipu now unleashed a thunderous blow to the pillar with his mace, and the pillar now split into two, and Lord Vishnu appeared from it with his dreadful form of Narasimha. Prem Sabaloshi Satyanarayan Bhagavan Ki. Satyanarayan Bhagavan Ki. Devotees, after tolerating all the abuse from Hiranyakashipu now, Prahlad is eventually saved by Narasimha, God Vishnu, in the form of a half lion and half man. You see, the bone that was given to Hiranyakashipu now, it began to unveil. And this is how. Remember, he could not be destroyed by a man nor animal. This was the first part of the bone. He was instead destroyed by half man, half lion. He could not be destroyed from someone who was born from a womb of a mother. Instead, he was destroyed by someone who came from a stone pillar. A stone pillar. He could not be destroyed neither on land or on air or in water. Narasimha placed him on his thighs, upon his thighs. He could not be destroyed by no man-made weapon. Narasimha destroyed him with his nails. He could not be destroyed either indoors or outdoors. He was destroyed at the entrance to his home. So you see how it's unveiling now? And he could not be destroyed during the day or the night. He was destroyed instead at dusk. This nullified all of Hiranyakashipu's boons of virtual immortality. So you see, do you see what this Abhimana Ahankar can cause? Even the boons that were given to him by Lord Brahma himself were unveiled. They were useless at this point. Not useless, but he could not surpass the glories of Satyanarayan Bhagavan. Prem Sabalosi Satyanarayan Bhagavan Ki Jai. Devotees, we sing the praises now. We glorify Bhagavan Shri Vishnu. Prahalad survived all the tortures and inflicted on him and came out unscathed. O Narayan, the bhajan tells us, O Narayan, master of this universe, victory to you. Your divine play is exceptionally unique, O Lord. Your greatness is overwhelming, O merciful Lord. You are the invincible, transcendental destroyer of worldly fears. O Lord, you infuse tranquility, happiness into the minds of people, and you transform this world of fears into freedoms. O Lord, take us under your protection, your shelter, your feet, O Lord, as we come before you and we sing.
Jai Jai Narayan Narayan Hari.
Bolo everyone, bolo, sing with me. Jai Jai Narayan Narayan Hari Hari.
Jai Jai Narayan Narayan Hari Hari. Swami Narayan Narayan Hari Hari. Jai Jai Narayan Narayan Hari Hari. Swami Narayan Narayan Hari Hari. तेरे लीला सबसे न्यारी न्यारी हरी हरी तेरी लीला सबसे न्यारी न्यारी हरी हरी तेरी महिमा सबसे न्यारी न्यारी हरी हरी जय जय नारायण नारायण हरी हरी स्वामी नारायण नारायण हरि हरि अलख निरंजन भाव भय भंजन जन मन रंजन दाता जन मन रंजन दाता हमें शरण दे अपने चरण में कर निर्भय जगताता कर निर्भय जगताता तूने लाखों की नैया तारी तारी हरि हरि
बोलो
जय जय नारायण नारायण हरि हरि स्वामी नारायण नारायण हरि हरि तेरी महिमा सबसे प्यारी प्यारी हरि हरि जय जय नारायण नारायण हरि हरि प्रभु का नाम के पारस को छोड़े वो हो जाए सोना वो हो जाए सोना दो अक्षर का शब्द हरि है लेकिन बड़ा सलोना लेकिन बड़ा सलोना उन्हें संकट के डाले भारी भारी हरि हरि
बोलो
जय जय नारायण नारायण हरि हरि स्वामी नारायण नारायण हरि हरि तेरी महिमा सबसे न्यारी न्यारी हरि हरि जय जय नारायण नारायण हरि हरि स्वामी नारायण नारायण हरि हरि जय जय नारायण नारायण
हरि हरि।
प्रेम से बोलो श्री सत्यनारायण भगवान की जय। नारायण जय नारायण। माय डियर डिवोटीज, व्हेन द लॉर्ड आस्क्ड प्रह्लाद इफ ही हैड नो फियर, प्रह्लाद रिप्लाइड, ही सेड टू मी, भगवान हे हरि, यू आर द एम्बॉडीमेंट ऑफ लव, I believe in your divine form of love and not this physical form. Devotees, do you? Do you believe in that divine form of Sri Hari? Narasimha then commanded Prahlad to take over the reins of the kingdom and transform the demons into virtuous beings and then come back to his divine abode. Prahlad then requested from the Lord to pardon his father and take him to heaven. After all the atrocities that his father dealt unto him, he asked the Lord, Satyanarayan Bhagavan, please take my father back to heaven. Would you do that if your parents were, hopefully your parents are not mean to you, but if you have a father like in this case, like Prahlad did, would you have asked the Lord to take your father back to home? Remember, he is practicing Satya Sanatan Vairik Dharma. Our Dharma teaches us Matru Deva Bhava, Pitru Deva Bhava. We stop right here. Mother and father are your first gods. Make no mistake, good, bad or evil. He asked his father to take him back to heaven. The Lord granted the boon. Eventually, Prahlad ruled over the world for a very long time with justice, with honor, and with righteousness. We must imbibe at least one quality of the great devotee Prahlad and practice in our daily lives, brothers and sisters. You should always remember that God, remember God, and chant his name and have his form in your mind in every single situation. I ask you this tonight. Well, a lot of us haven't been driving lately, right? Because we're locked down. But when the lockdown is over and you do step into your cars, I want you, as you open that door and to sit into your car, please, if you do not already do, place a murti of Bhagwan or a picture of Bhagwan on the console somewhere. And the first words you should chant as you sit in that car, even before putting the key into the ignition, is Jai Shri Ram, Jai Narayan, Jai Devi Ma. Call the name of Bhagwan. Ask Bhagwan to guide you and take you, carry you wherever safely and bring you back home safely. And when you were to arrive at your destination, call the name of Bhagwan. Give praise and thanks, devotees. These little simple practices in Namasmaran, remembering the name of God, they speak volumes and they yield tremendous immaculate rewards, devotees. You know that meditation is such an important part of your devotion. It is so important that we use this precious time now to connect with God within our hearts. Chanting the name of God, listening to his glories are all very important. Eh? But as connecting with the source now and quietening our minds so that everything we are listening to or listen to saturates within. I do not want you to forget the teachings at 9 o'clock tonight as soon as Katha is finished. Eh? I want this to be absorbed and energized and put it into your system, engraved into your system. Let us take a few minutes now to relax and pause as we go into the next segment of Shivoham. We are going to do 3 Oms first, then 3 Gayatris, and of course, 11 Om Namah Shivaya. As we start with 3 Oms, sit upright if you can. Inhale. Om. Again. We chant 3 Gayatri mantras. Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha Tatsavitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Naha Prachodayat. Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha Tatsavitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Naha Prachodayat. Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Naha Prachodayat. Om. Now, 11 times we chant Om Namah Shivaya. Deep breath. Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Om Namah
शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय। प्रेम से बोलो महापति महादेव की जय। Devotees, we now go into silent sitting. We sit upright once again. In a comfortable position on the floor, with our legs crossed. Make sure our back is straight, our head is upright. We take a deep breath, we relax, and we breathe out. Let that feeling of love grow in your hearts. Let it spread through you. Think of someone you know who is ill or hurt and send that love to them. Let your love spread further and further to everyone, to the animals, the birds, to all creatures and to plants everywhere. Now bring your attention back to where you are. Gently open your eyes and stretch. Smile at the person next to you. How do you feel? Now, it's time for Growing Pearls of Kindness, our children's series. And it is my hope that these stories will instill faith and remind our young generation, our younger generation, that they are God's children and we are their earthly guardians, to be kind and to make a positive difference in this world. Children, I hope that your pearls of kindness at home, you are continuing to grow these, and that you are helping your parents, whether it's making up the bed, doing the dishes, tidying up your rooms, sweeping the floor, or just keeping the house nice and clean, healthy, making a difference. Children and everyone in this broadcast, I want you to listen to this story tonight. It is called The Grass-Eating Tiger. The Grass-Eating Tiger. One day, a shepherd saw a strange sight from afar. A tigress had just given birth to a little cub and it was laying dead. The shepherd, he felt sad, so he brought the little cub home and fed it and brought it up along with his sheep. Could you imagine a little tiger cub with a sheep? Now the little cub grew up, but he ate just the food that the sheep ate, which was grass. He even bleated like them. And he romped and rambled like a sheep. One day a great thing happened. A huge tiger passed by the sheep and the cub and saw, to his surprise, this young tiger cub eating grass and bleating like sheep. He jumped amidst the sheep and they all ran away bleating fearfully. The cub too ran away bleating, but then the tiger caught up with the cub and took him to a pool of water nearby and said, "Look, look at the reflection in the water. You are a tiger just like me, the king of animals. Stop bleating and eating grass. Be a tiger and roar." The young tiger came to know his true nature. His true nature. Questions tonight. Very short story, but it's very meaningful. How did you feel, children, when you listen, and adults, when you listen to this story? Did it remind you of something in your own lives? Do you know it's not about the color of your skin or where you have come from or what you look like that matters? Did we know this, children? Do you know it is what is in your heart and your mind that counts the most? How kind and truthful you are? And most importantly, do you know that God is always listening to you? The learning lessons today. Through prayers, silent sitting, and Nama Smaran, the recitation of the name of Bhagwan, like the tiger cub who thought that he was a sheep, we think we are the body only, but we are not the body. We are part of God who resides in the cave, the heart. I want you to say to your parents tonight and your siblings around you, I know that God is always with me. I know that God is always with me. Everywhere and in everything. I understand that what I think, what I say, and what I do has an effect on others as well as myself, and that every being needs love and kindness. I will choose to be kind to you and everyone, to all animals, plants, and planet Earth. To all animals, plants, and planet Earth. I love you. Type it into your chats, those of you on Facebook Live and on YouTube as well. And those of you listening on Akashvani and Swarg, say to each other, say to yourself, I love you. Because you're speaking to God. Type it into your chat windows. I love you. I love you all. Discuss with your parents, devotees, children. How can we know our real nature? Another act of kindness, and continue to grow and growing your strands of pearls of devotion. So very important. And now, to recap our katha tonight. It's been an absolute wonderful evening this evening. Powerful, energetic, vibrant. And I hope that you will come again and again and again. Join us for future. Saturday we go again. 11th edition of Shivoham. Our conclusion. Adi Shankara, who composed this beautiful meaning prayer, Chidananda Rupah Shivoham Shivoham the Nirvana Shatakam. He knew that non-dualism requires intense spiritual effort of will to remove all traces of ego, all ideas of duality from the minds of the human being. So as a preparatory discipline to dawn of the awareness of one's real unity with the substance of the universe, he taught us the rules of yoga. Yoga, union with the divine, and devotion as well as karma. These, according to him, will brighten the intellect, cleanse the emotions, and purify the heart. Remember, charity, unity, purity, divinity, atma tattva. Our ultimate goal in life. And how do we get there? Chidananda Rupa Shivoham Shivoham. Devotees, of everything that we have talked about this evening, what has meant the most to you? Or what is the one thing that you would go and think about more after this satsang tonight? I want you to type it into the chat windows. Tell me in your own words, please. Type it in. Chat window on Facebook and YouTube Live. And those of you who are on Akashvani and Swarg, you can WhatsApp me as well. 954-325-7712. 954-325-7712. The question they ask is, of everything that we have talked about this evening, what has meant the most to you? Or what is the one thing that you will take away from this katha tonight and think more about? I want you to type it into the chat windows. Tell us. Tell me. Tonight, before we close, I would like to dedicate this next bhajan to a dear brother of mine, one of the greatest souls on this planet that I know and I have known. I call him my brother from another mother. He lives in a place called Jarodhakalan, which is a suburb of the outskirts of New Delhi in India. And we have known each other for over 15 years now. A simple, humble, unique, and blessed soul, I tell you. Tonight, my dear brother Shailesh Mishra and all his neighbors who are listening in that colony in Jarodhakalan, it is wee hours of the morning, but they are tuned in. They are locked in tonight to Facebook Live. And to all those others, Shailesh Ji, Pooja Ji, and your children, Bulbul, and of course, Aditya Ji. To all those who are struggling to cope with the trials and tribulations of daily life due to COVID-19 and any other worldly circumstances, we call upon Mahavir Swami. Mahavir Swami, because today is Tuesday, Mangalwar. Mahavir Swami Hanuman Baba, to relieve us from this pain and suffering of this pandemic. And to those of you who have lost jobs, we ask for the blessings of Mahavir Swami. There's a ritual, a puja, that you can perform by yourselves. You don't need a pundit for this. Please don't hate me for saying this, but it's I speak from my heart. If you are interested, it will help you in your seek for employment. You can please message me, send me a WhatsApp message, or the information to contact me should be up on the screen here very shortly. Feel free to get in touch with me. I'll be more than happy to share this with you. We sing now to this Pavanaputra Hanumanji, your Lord and Master, as we glorify him. Victory to you, O Hanuman. Jai, 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 Hanuman Gosai. Have mercy, O Hanumanji. I want to hear all of your beautiful voices blended and sing. Sing to the top of your voices tonight. By your spiritual energies, our bodies strengthened and our minds pervaded by devotion. Whoever has come to your court, O Lord, have been relieved of their suffering and pain. Hence we come to you, O Mahavir. You are the Lord of the unhappy and the poor. You rejoice in the service of Sri Ram, Lakshman and Mother Sita. By tearing open your chest, O Lord, you have bestowed great glorious sight. And your heart, O Lord, is the abode of Prabhu Sri Ram. We sing.
Begi haro hanu man mahaprabhu jo kachhu sankat hoye hamaro kaun so sankat mor garib ko jo tumse nahi jaat hai taro.
You know it, sing along with me.
Jai 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 Hanuman Gosai, Kripa Karo Maharaj. Jai 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 Hanuman Gosai, Kripa Karo Maharaj. तन में तुम्हारे शक्ति विराजे मन भक्ति से बीना जो जन तुम्हारी शरण में आए जो जन तुम्हारी शरण में आए दुख दर्द हर लीना हनुमत दुख दर्द हर लीना महावीर प्रभु हम दुखियन के महावीर प्रभु हम दुखियन के तुम हो गरीब निवाज हनुमत तुम हो गरीब निवाज हनुमत जय 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 हनुमान गोसाई कृपा करो महाराज राम लखन रे यही तुम पर सदा रहे हर्षाए राम लखन वही यही तुम पर सदा रहे हर्षाए हृदय चीर के राम सिया का हृदय चीर के राम सिया का दर्शन दिया कराए हनुमत दर्शन दिया कराए दो कर जोरी अरज हनुमंता दो कर जोरी अरज हनुमंता कहियो प्रभु से आज हनुमत कहियो प्रभु से आज हनुमत जय 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 हनुमान गोसाई कृपा करो महाराज जय 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 अनुमान गोसाई कृपा करो महाराज जय 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 हनुमान गोसाई कृपा करो महाराज
प्रेम से बोलो पवन पुत्र हनुमान की महावीर स्वामी की जय 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 हनुमान जी डिवोटीज बिफोर वी क्लोज टुनाइट आफ्टर द लास्ट सेशन ऑन सैटरडे नाइट I received numerous requests from so many of you for more inspirational messages like the one we collectively meditated upon, written by Miss Seema Diwan, one of my most favorite writers. I'll share another message, very short one tonight, as we're almost out of time this evening. First, I want you to close your eyes and imagine your favorite form of God, even your Ishta Devata, seated right here to the center of the Ajna Chakra. And that form of God is speaking to you. Meditation is forgetting yourself and becoming myself. God is speaking, eh, Bhagavan? I repeat. Meditation is forgetting yourself and becoming myself. I am nothing but pure love. Fill every cell of yours with my love and feel my bliss enter. To realize you as me is true meditation. Learn to give love. Give love. Give love. Do good. Close your eyes. And hear my words of encouragement when you do good. This is nothing but the beginning of my communication with you. Strengthen this communication with me through your good actions. This in turn will give you peace. When your mind is calm and the heart is full of love, your meditation will be automatic. Brothers and sisters, open your eyes and breathe. Tonight, we give praise and thanks now. We sing, Katha Visarjana Hotu Hai सुनो वीर हनुमान रामा लक्ष्मण जान की सदा करो कल्याण प्रेम से बोलो भगवान रामचंद्र की सत्य सनातन धर्म की
कथा विसर्जन होत है सुनो वीर हनुमान रामा लक्ष्मण जान की सदा करो कलिया एक घड़ी आदो घड़ी आदो में पुनियार तुलसी संघट सारी के कटे खोटे अपराध ओ जो जन जहां से आए हो हो जो जन जहां से आए हो जो जन जहां से आए हो कथा सुनो मन लाए अपने अपने ध्याम को विदा होत हर्षाय श्रोता सब आसन गए शंभु गए कैलाश
रामायण मम हृदय महान आन करहु तुम पास ओ रामा लक्ष्मण जानकी हो रामा लक्ष्मण जानकी रामा लक्ष्मण जानकी भरत शत्रुहन भाय कथा विसर्जन होटु है एक शीशन भाय धन्य घरी वाहयादि की जहाँ होट हरिनाम नड़के कौन्य कलाई जड़ी गई ये वहाँ जाए
प्रेम से बोलो भगवान रामचंद्र की जय Devotees, we sit upright for a few minutes now. As we clasp our hands, we gently bow our heads and close our eyes in prayer. We give praise and thanks to Bhagwan this evening for bringing us, giving us this opportunity to assemble like this in satsang, to sing, to chant, to glorify His name, and to listen to the holy scriptures. Bless all those who attended from near and far, O Lord, and those who could not be here for one reason or the other. We ask that Your guiding hands be upon one and all, O Lord. Bless those who are sick and suffering, O Lord, those who are homeless, those who are jobless, those who are helpless. We ask, O Lord, Your name who has helped the blind to see and the crippled to climb the highest mountain and the mute to speak eloquently. We come before You, Lord. Tvameva mata cha pita tvameva tvameva bandhuscha sakha tvameva tvameva vidya dravinam tvameva tvameva sarvam mama deva deva asto ma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityurma Amritam Gamaya From untruth, lead us on to truth. From darkness, lead us on to light. And from death, lead us on to eternal life. O Bhagwan, we ask and beg and beseech you, O Lord, to accept us, O Lord. Give us your blessings, O Lord. Darshan Deduna.
शिव हरे शिव राम सके प्रभु त्रिविदुताप निवारण हे विभु अज जनेश्वर यादव पाहि माम शिव हरे विजयम कुरु मे बलम प्रतिदिनम कुशलम जय मंगलम प्रतिदिनम कुशलम जय मंगलम प्रतिदिनम कुशलम जय मंगलम गजाननम सरस्वती शिवा चतुर्भुजं नमामि ओम शरण्यनम नमामि ते करोत जो विकंचनम सदैव मंगलम कुरु गया प्रयाग नैमिषार्को सस्तनी च मथुरा हरिपुरिश्च कौंसिले सिकासी दुर्गरस्तुथा करोत जो विकंचनम सदैव मंगलम कुरु मत्स्य कुरुम वामनम नरसिंह रूप राहरि व्यासस्त राम कृष्णयो कलंकी बोध वस्तुथा करोत जो भी कंचनम सदैव मंगलम कुरु ओम मंगलम भगवान विष्णु मंगलम गरुड़ध्वज मंगलम पुंडरीकाक्ष मंगलायतरो हरि समस्त लोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्त लोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्त लोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु परमं पवित्रं बावा विभूति परमं विचित्रं लीला विभूतिं परमात्मैस्तार्थ मोक्ष प्रधानं बावा विभूतिं इदमाश्रयामि परमं पवित्रं बाबा विभूति परमं विचित्रं लीला विभूति
समस्त लोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्त लोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्त लोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु ओम शांति 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 ही
प्रेम से बोलो गजानन स्वामी की उमापति महादेव की सत्य सनातन धर्म की प्रभु रामचंद्र भगवान की पवन पुत्र हनुमान की आज शक्ति देवी भवानी शंकर माता की शिवोहम की नमो पार्वते पतये हर हर महादेव
जय 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 सीताराम सबको नमस्ते सस्त्रयाकाल जय गुरुदत्ता ओम साई राम ओम नमः शिवाय कोटि 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 धन्यवाद डिवोटीज थैंक यू सो मच for giving me your attention, for this sharing your time, your precious time with us this evening for the past 2 hours and a few minutes. Sorry, we went a little bit over this evening. To all of the media houses, Akash, Vani, 106.5 FM, DJ Mamu, Kavita Narayan, thank you very much. To Swarg HD, Hema Ram Narayanji, thank you very much. To all of you on Facebook Live and YouTube Live as well, friends, relatives, brothers and sisters, thank you, thank you, thank you so much for this wonderful evening of devotion. We'll see you again on Saturday night, something very special on the 11th edition of Shivoham. We'll see you then. And now we sing our closing bhajan. Om Namah Shivaya. Blend your voices, sing along with us as we chant and we sing. Om Namah Shivaya. Prem se bolo Mahapati Mahadeva ki. Let us glorify him. Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya, Rameshwara Shiva Rameshwara, Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya. Rameshwara Shiva Rameshwara Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Om Gangadhara Shiva Gangadhara Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Gangadhara Shiva Gangadhara Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Namah Shivaya Namah Shivaya Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Jatadhara Shiva Jatadhara Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Jatadhara Shiva Jatadhara Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Namah Shivaya Namah Shivaya Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Namah Shivaya Namah Shivaya Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Someshwara Shiva Someshwara Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Someshwara Shiva Someshwara Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Namah Shivaya Namah Shivaya Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Namah Shivaya Namah Shivaya Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya Vishveshwara Shiva Vishveshwara Har Har Bhole Namah Shivaya
विश्वेश्वरा शिव विश्वेश्वरा हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय कोटेश्वरा शिव कोटेश्वरा हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय कोटेश्वरा शिव कोटेश्वरा हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय महाकालेश्वरा महाकालेश्वरा हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय महाकालेश्वरा महाकालेश्वरा हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय शिव नामा शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय शिव नामा शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय हर हर भोले नमः शिवाय शांति 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 ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय नमो पार्वती पतये हर हर महादेव जय जय सीताराम सबको धन्यवाद साई राम जय गुरुदत्ता थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस वंस अगेन फॉर दिस आवर 10th एडिशन ऑफ शिवोहम विल सी यू अगेन ऑन सैटरडे 7 to 9 PM for 11th edition of Shivoham. In the meantime, those of you who have not done so yet, please like this page, Pandit Neel Dev Prasad. Please like the page and make sure you're also accepting notifications. This way, you'll be aware and notified of all of our future live broadcasts. Thank you so much for all of you for joining once again from near and far, wherever you are, for taking this time this evening to be with us here on Shivoham. On behalf of my son, Pandit Keshav, and myself, we say to you, Jai Jai Sitaram Sabkoi, Jai Bholenath. Thank you. God bless you. Have a peaceful, wonderful evening, rest of week, and we'll see you again on Saturday. Jai Bholenath, Jai Shiva Shankar, Om Namah Shivaya.